presentation will be divided mainly in three parts. I will briefly tell about myself and my academic interests. After Indra, I will try to do it really fast. Then I will tell the background information about the development of social care in Latvia, because like this conference, like truly international, and we have people from USA, India, and my aim is to make my presentation like to really for you to really learn something about Baltic states and Latvia. And then I will say, and we'll show you more cases of historiography of Latvia on the aspect of history of humanitarian aid organizations and some available sources, and some are so virtual sources you can use. So I'm a PhD student, and the thesis is social care in Latvia, end of 19th century till 1940. And exactly example of municipality in Riga. And as far as you can see, I'm social historian. Sometimes I joke like social historian is that kind of historian that need knowledge in military, economic, cultural, intellectual, and etc. history, like to put the puzzle on to collect all the information and sources. And I mostly write about most vulnerable groups in society, and I research social care institutions like orphanages, elderly and institutions for elderly or disabled people, asylums, nursery homes, mainly in capital of Latvia, Riga. And I also work in a museum of history of Riga and navigation. So, and my thesis developed from master thesis. It was about orphanages in Riga in interwar time. And bachelor thesis was like in gender studies, so it's political work of female organizations in interwar time. And socio-political organizations also included this social aim to work with most vulnerable groups in society. And history of humanitarian organizations is a part of my thesis, because it is important to mention that global humanitarian organizations, a lot of which are existing till nowadays in Latvia, also shifted national social policy in Latvia. So from global humanitarian organization till the national local ones. And so history. The founding of national Latvian social policy and its development is complicated topic. First, Latvian social policy was developed from the welfare policy from Russian Empire in modern 19th century. Second, Russian Empire followed the German welfare social system, where Baltic German humanitarian voluntary organizations played important role. In capital of nowadays Latvia, Riga was one of the first places in Russian Empire, while ideas of welfare system remained. So main principles: decentralization, individualization, understanding of human social responsibility based on Christian values, as well as female activity factor in big industrial, municipal, urbanized areas. In 19th century, orphans and disabled people were separated in different orphanages and asylums by nationality and confession, as well as other specific social care, mainly private at the time social care institutions. And even in interwar Latvia, this principle might find it. Here, most specific is to establishment of Hebrew voluntary social organizations, because Jews were not included in municipalities of poor relief. Also, Latvians who just became realized that we are Latvians, had two options: to realize social work institutions in Russian, in those Russian Empire's institutions, or establish Latvian ones on private ways. So volunteering charity and humanitarian organizations were important in national awakening. Capital Riga statistically was the first among five St. Petersburg, Moscow, Odessa and Warsaw biggest cities in empire for the poor relief aid. Riga was third biggest city in Russian Empire after St. Petersburg and Moscow by its number of industrial workers. Riga became a platform, like a bridge for both West and East novelties in technology, culture, and ideas in social care. And then came World War One, time when we can speak about global humanitarian organizations in Latvia. Journalist Jackie Storer wrote at the anniversary of World War One in 2014. This was an inescapable war in which whole societies had to be mobilized in a way they had not been before. Men who have never contemplated violence were conscripted into it. Women who had never imagined themselves manufacturing explosives or digging the land were doing just that. Children who just wanted to play when hungry were bombed from the air and became orphans. Since 1918, when Latvia, among other European countries, gained independence, as elsewhere in the war situation after World War One is well known as humanitarian awakening, and therefore also a lot of humanitarian organizations activated or well established. For Latvia, it was first time to become a part of global international humanitarian movement. International organizations like American Relief Administration, Rada Barnen, as well as the establishment of International Save the Children Fund, well, important because the wartime in Latvia was for 5 years. Baltics, especially Latvia and Riga, was one of the Europe's most ruined regions. Why? Because wartime lasted for almost 5 years, from 1915, when the start of World War One in territory of Latvia, till 1920s, when Latvia and Russia signed an agreement on territories. After 1918, World War ended, but Latvia, as well as other Baltic states, continue to be in wartime. We had so-called independence wars. Most tragic moment is that different political regimes, armies, remained in those for 2 years. And also we had for those 2 years almost 15 armies, like 15 different armies. That mean also separations, us and them, heroes and enemies, and etc. And that means also we can speak about a lot of different war traumas generation after World War One faced. For example, in one of the archive sources I read, the previously happy family was ruined. Father, ex-army officer, became alcoholic, and previously good mother, no, was in a psychiatric clinic. And the kid, previously excellent student, is put in orphanage because of begging. And it's like only one case. That's why it is important to thank those who also helped Latvians and not only Latvians, but all inhabitants of Latvia to rescue after wartime. And it's a time to remember and thank global humanitarian organizations. Important to mention that we established our country on 18th of November 1918, still in wartime. Needed to say that the support of American global humanitarian organizations was crucial, because that also means not only food, clothes for army, and what was mostly important, it was kind of diplomacy. In a previous session, we also had like this technology of making policy. So of course those organizations, well, as politically neutral as they could, but we still cannot forget the factor of that this support means sympathy to Latvians and support to be internationally recognized as a state. International humanitarian organizations were factors of creating the support and Latvian national social care institutions. Almost all global humanitarian organizations became future centers of where national social policy were realized. The aim of this topic is to show historiography and available primary sources for researching the international humanitarian actions in Baltic region, with case study of orphanages and hospices in Riga. In this paper, concrete academic literature sources, some available sources will be shown, and sources mainly from National Archive of Latvia and National Library of Latvia and some museum materials. And so now I will mention concrete humanitarian either institutions with historiographical analyze, and as well as will mention available literature and sources. First of all, I need to mention that Soviet time almost remembers about help of international humanitarian organizations. So after Latvia was occupied in 1940, incorporated in Soviet Union, our knowledge about the bureaucratic independence Republic of Latvia was deleted from research and social memory. Therefore, we have huge contradiction in fact that the amount of, so, like, you have tons of sources, and the amount of academical and even popular literatures, like, just started to exist. So one of the newest and fullest academical research is offered of my scientific curator, Professor Erik C. Jakobsons, and it is book issued in 2018, like, huge. It was anniversary since proclamation of independence of Latvia, and important that Jakobsons used sources from Latvia as well as historian. He has worked in Hoover Institution several times during the past decade. And this 800-page monograph is mainly on relations between Latvia and United States, with special emphasis on American aid that Cuban country during 1918-1922. The publication is based mostly on documentation found at Hoover archives and is richly illustrated with photographs from Hoover holdings. As far as I know, book... there are like two parts, like those diplomatic relationships and humanitarian organizations and American interest in Baltic region and Latvia during World War One, and immediately after was mostly in the context of events in Germany and Russia. The Latvian delegation was present in the Paris Peace Conference in 1919, but only in an observer's role. The United States and France, less now Britain, wanted to see democratic Russia and its old borders, which left little room for the national aspirations for non-Russian majorities of the Baltic region. Little room for the national aspirations of non-Russian majorities of the Baltic region. Nonetheless, direct contacts gradually developed and intensified in early spring of 1919, when American Relief Administration, ARA, headed by Cuban, began its humanitarian aid work in interwar-devastated region. The presence of ARA was essential for survival of the local populations, especially its most vulnerable segment, children. Some 30% of Latvian children received various forms of help from Americans, food, clothing, medical assistance, etc. The effort was extremely complicated by its continuing occupation of parts of ARA by German, Bolshevik and anti-Bolshevik forces, as I mentioned before, like in total 15 armies, as well as political and social divisions within Latvian society. Such problems are contested control of port facilities, lack of rolling stock and financial house, all contributed to operating difficulties. Politically, the United States continued to be committed to the restoration of a non-Bolshevik Russia at the expense of the recognition of the Baltic states of Latvia, Lithuania and Estonia. It was not until 1922, a year after Treaty joined the League of Nations and Bolsheviks won the civil war in Russia, that the United States extended its recognition to Latvia and the other Baltic states. Besides the work of ARA, Erik C. Jakobsons traces the activities of other American organizations, American Red Cross, Young Men's Christian Association, Young Women Christian Association, American Jewish Joint Distribution Committee. There were hundreds of Americans working in Latvia during those years, government workers, military officers, medical staff, office personnel, technicians, etc. One of the most prominent and well-remembered was Thomas Orbison, chief of ARA's Latvian mission from 1919 to 1920, whose papers are available in Hoover archives. American presence in Baltic states in the first year of World War I, much of it based in Riga, was the most intense in history. Its legacy was the friendly relationships between the United States and Baltic states during the interwar period and deep American sympathy for the people of the region, sympathy that underlines their lack of recognition of Soviet incorporation of Latvia, Lithuania and Estonia during the dark decades of Soviet domination in Eastern Europe in 20th century. Latvian Red Cross was founded in November 20, 1918, at the suggestion of Dr. Janis Jankovskis after the initiative of the mission of American Red Cross. Its initial assistance focused on the care and assistance of wounded, mutilated and nailed, as well as released prisoners of war. In 1920s, the society set the protection and care of public health as the goal of its activity. The structure of Latvian Red Cross included several regional departments, hospitals, sanatoriums, schools, of nursing houses, pharmacies, workshop, ambulance, transport, health care points, publishing activities, and other institutions. The Latvian Red Cross was the largest organization in Latvia until 1940, when it was incorporated into the Red Cross of the Union of the Soviet Socialist Republic, USSR, and functioned as the Red Cross Committee of Latvian SSR until 1991, when it resumed its activities. Therefore, Latvian Red Cross was almost the exception in Soviet historiography. It was researched and it was mentioned as well. And here it's important, like about Latvian Red Cross was researched by medicine historian with medicine background, like not medicine historians, but like historian background, for example, Arnis Vigsne. And so yeah, and about sources, I want to present you the virtual exhibition made by Latvian State Archive and of audiovisual documents of National Archive of Latvia. So you can visit this one, Redzirdi Latvian, its collection. So its activities. Also, you can visit Latvian National Joint Catalog, putting here separate keywords in Latvian, trying to translate Latvia Sarkanais Krust, means Latvian Red Cross. And speaking about archive, we have like for all of these organizations, we have like separate funds. And for example, Latvian Red Cross counts together 5,321 files, and plus something like 2,000 of youth Red Cross. Therefore, we had like trying to introduce in different exhibitions about Latvian Red Cross, but there was like a lack of this information about its time as American Red Cross activities in Latvia. And last but not least, the aspect of humanitarian aid was something I started my research during my master's, is establishing, Eglantine Jep was mentioned, and it's international organizations that focus on child care, and mainly I need to pay your attention again on Save the Children Fund. So Save the Children type organization all around Europe and even the world developed international ideas into national ideas, how to realize social policy, how to provide best social care for mothers and their children, to orphans and etc. And in Latvia we had, like in Bulgarian, so the same. This was like really helpful for me to develop my research. So in Latvia we had even two Save the Children organization, and during interwar time, and the mission was ended. Like first one is Latvian Children's AIDS Union, established in 21, again when the American mission ended in our territory. And we had like other ones, like two Save the Children typed organizations. So it's like to show how important for us, and like in Estonia also, like those one were like Save the Children organization and Catholic and female organization in Lithuanian case. And what was like totally, it's like Lithuanians had also interesting archive exhibitions, virtual archive exhibitions. And they are about also wartime, female, and of course also like partly about this Lithuanian Mother Achievement Law Organizations Union. So, but what's interesting, in 1928, all these Save the Children type organizations they had Baltic Committee of Protecting Children and Mothers, founded in 1928. and it was kind of like really interesting. And other humanitarian organization based on help of children was Vedeshrada Barnen, Save the Children Sweden, and is the name of Swedish section of Save the Children International. The Swedish section was founded in November 19, 1919, so 3 years before Latvian one. So an interesting fact is that therefore one of the most excellent child educator, Marta Rinka, she was a director of kindergarten for poor children called Green School, and she, during the wartime in 1919, she wrote to this Rada Barnen, to the Swedish organization, and asked for help, and they answered and even sent us some amount of money. And it's about like, yeah, international relationships, small fact, but well. And main authors, without means, that mentions those child care missions, Janis Riekstins, but again, like only in one book, he has like this interwar time and this American humanitarianism organization. Another, you can see like what she has about Bolshevism, and then he has researches mainly after World War II. And in Lithuanian and also Vineta Juanite, she wrote about the Smarterinka and the history of kindergartens and orphanages in Latvia. And this fact about Martarinka was mentioned. And in Lithuanian case, this Italian historian living in Lithuania, even in English, this book, yeah, Lithuanians are, yeah, this one, Andrea Grifante, and it's in English in Palgrave, so yeah. So almost all Latvian social care institutions realize children's social care. And among them also Latvian Women Relief Corps. And here it's interesting, we'll tell you why. And this was established again by example of foreign United Kingdom's Women Defense Relief Corps. In 1920, when Latvian independence ended, Corps established orphanage for orphans. In total, in this orphanage, around 80 orphans were raised up. Therefore, World War One was like a professional playground for a woman in ex-territorium of Russian Empire. It was also interesting, this case of this Merciful Sisters of Charity of Red Cross, because like we know, like Red Cross is established in 1863, so in 19th century, but as you can see in Latvia, we have only established Latvian one after after American humanitarian organization. So Russian sociologist Elena Kostina writes the charity Sister in territory of Russian had two directions. First is Crimea Wars, Christovos Vizhenska, Merciful Sisters Church. So when this church was established, it was like first direction. Second one was after International Red Cross 4 years later, like in 1867, when it became Russian Red Cross. And so those women called like, yes, Merciful Sisters, Sestry Milosrdnie. So the question is about like could Latvian female could be one of those sisters?
Anastasia, you have just a minute left.
Okay, so yeah.
Can you wind up? Yes.
I'm very close to my conclusions. So, and only actually it was like really a rare situation when Latvian women became this Merciful Sister, because first of all, education, and it was those were only girls from really, really actually wealthiest families. So for Latvian, it was like not really, really, really the case for this time. So yeah. And this is in archive sources. So, and what's important, I cannot see. Yeah, archive sources. I can send you later, like periodic Puntselva in Russian, about periodics. So yeah, international humanitarian organizations is important factor for us. because their activity is a first step to establish national branches of those organizations and to become a part of international understanding of how social work should look like. And international humanitarian aid organization not only saved a lot of lives of inhabitants of independent Latvia, but established diplomatic relationships and also Latvian society understands themselves as socially responsible society in the humanitarian era, as everywhere in Europe in after World War One. What's the best experience for nowadays historiography is this book of Erik Jakobson, and he was to show us that analyze not only local archive, Latvian archives, but also using sources from foreigner archives is pretty important. So yeah, I'm going to continue his work and thank you a lot.